Our teachers, in this episode, I'm going to give you 10 fresh and new ideas for back to school in your art classroom. These are all ready to go ideas that you can use in your classroom that have a lovely back to school vibe and will have your classroom set up for success for the year. I'm going to give you ideas for how you can encourage some growth mindset, community builders, icebreakers, and a bunch of other ideas to set your first couple months up for success. Then I'm also going to give you ideas to project onto your year, so that way you have a kind of a game plan for the year. And yes, grab my action item at the very end, because it's going to help you get going. All right, so these ready-to-do ideas are going to have your students in your art classroom exploring art mediums, experimenting, and being creative. I got you, my lovely friends. All right, let's get into it.
You're listening to the Miss Artastic Podcast, inspiration for art teachers. Here's your host, Kathleen McGivern.
Hello, my lovely friends, and welcome back to the Ms. Artastic Podcast. I am your host, Kathleen McGivern, and yes, I am Ms. Artastic, and I create art resources, lessons, and YouTube videos for kids. I curate and write articles for the Ms. Artastic blog, which you can find at msartastic.com. Also, that is where all my show notes are, in case you're wondering, where you can grab all the links. I create weekly drawing videos for kids on the Ms. Artastic YouTube channel. I create this podcast, and I also have my membership for art teachers called the Artastic Collective, which, by the way, is opening for enrollment this August, my friends. If you're an art teacher and you want an art curriculum that is going to have you like ready to go for, well, at least the next 2 years or so, then you need to check out the Artastic Collective. That's where you're going to grab all my Ms. Artastic resources for a fabulous deal. Otherwise, you can grab them individually in my TPT store. But check that out. It's going to be opening in the first week of August. Oh, yeah. I'm also going to be having my Pastel Extravaganza free webinar. That's also going to be launching in that first week. So make sure you go on over to artasticcollective.com in that first week. So much is happening, including my free webinar where I'm going to teach you two art projects for free that you can use in your back to school weeks or first month. You'll be making an example with me. I'm going to teach you how to do them. And yes, we're exploring both soft pastels and oil pastels. And both art projects are in a back to school themed kind of fun imagery. So make sure you check that out. If you need art resources or lessons, this of course is the place to be. From my membership to my Teachers Pay Teachers store, Ms. Artastic, I can provide you with anything you need to teach a stellar art lesson. All right, let's get on into this episode and my 10 ideas that you can use for back to school. First is art classroom community builders and icebreakers for art teachers. I love creating activities that help my students learn who their classmates are, allow me to get to know them faster, especially like when you have hundreds of students, and also kids to explore making art. I love those kinds of things. This is why I always start my year with community building and icebreakers. This is also a classroom management strategy because you're getting to know your students, and you should also be sharing who you are to your students to help earn their trust. Some students need a little bit more convincing so that they can trust you, so give them the opportunity right away to let them learn who you are. Sometimes the reluctant learners in your classroom really need to build a relationship with you before they are ready to learn from you. Design some community builders for your classroom that let you learn who your students are, but also let them explore art at the same time. Art-themed community builders are perfect. So make sure you're like thinking of some ideas and design some for your classroom that are going to help you get to know your students, let your students know who you are, but also it introduces them to different art mediums and just opportunities to be creative and experimenting and exploring making art just for fun. However, if you just want to grab community builders that are ready to use, I have a fully planned and ready to use community builder resource in my TPT store. 10 back-to-school community builders and icebreakers specifically designed for an art classroom to allow for both community building and exploration of mediums and materials while providing the teacher an opportunity to learn about their students and make observations. Grab that link in the show notes of this podcast. So I'll have the link in my podcast show notes, or you can visit the back to school section of my Teachers Pay Teachers store. Simply search Ms. Artastic on TPT and click that little category in the left side that says back to school, and that's going to take you to all my back to school resources. So make sure you check it out or find the link in my show notes of this podcast, link in the description. All right, the next thing that you should definitely do in your art classroom, especially if you're teaching elementary, is to have some art centers for your art classroom. You can even create art centers for middle school or high school levels, just leveling them up to different things. So for instance, if you're doing like a grid drawing at an elementary level, you can make grid drawings for middle school and high school that are definitely more complex, right? So that could be a when you're done, but also an art center, or you can have like your sketchbook prompts or whatever, right? So that would be an art center at a higher level. But art centers are a great way to get your students exploring and creating art in the first week or so of your classroom. It is a good strategy and idea for easing them into exploring art mediums, getting used to your classroom and learning about you, and just simply easing into being a creative thinker. Sometimes, like, some people are really eager to make art and to be creative and try mediums and not worry about just exploring, right? But not everybody's used to being a creative thinker. So we have to be able to assume that we need to make our classroom flexible for all learners and all types of thinkers. And just easing them into being creative thinkers with art centers is ideal, no matter what age, right? Because everybody has different experiences and exposure to art, so we need to just make our classroom flexible for everyone. So art centers are a great way, again, to let your students be exploring art and being creative and just easing them into that process. So put them in bins and rotate students through centers, or use them as various center activities through the year. So like once you make it, it is ready to go. And during back to school, you're teaching your kids how to use these art centers. And then those can be your when you're done activities or bell ringers during the year. So art teachers, these are also perfect when you're done activities and bell ringers in your classroom. Use them in your first week to get kids exploring. And then once they know how to use them, let those be your when you're done activities for your students throughout the year, as they already know how to use them. You've already done the training, and of course, it's already prepped. So design your own, or if you would like to just grab mine, you can grab my ready-to-use art centers in my Teachers Pay Teachers store, Ms. Artastic. Find the resource in the back-to-school section of my store area or in the show notes of this episode, which is on my blog, so you can just grab that link and check it out. So next thing is that you should definitely teach growth mindset in your art classroom. I talk about growth mindset a lot. It is so important, especially it's a useful like community building strategy. It teaches kids just strategies for not giving up when making art and just like going with the flow, or if they make mistakes, not to get all, creative block over that, or like unwilling to create. Sometimes people, if they make a mistake, just totally shut down, and this is going to help prevent that. I definitely teach growth mindset. It is essential, and I've talked about it a lot. If you've been following my Ms. Artastic stuff, either on my YouTube channel, my blog, or whatever, I talk about growth mindset a lot. So growth mindset for your art classroom: promote resiliency and determination among your students. It's perfect for pairing with growth mindset lessons, or you can use it with growth mindset coloring pages while you talk about it. Teaching art to kids is a dream. A perfect job where you get to be creative and experiment while inspiring young minds to do the same. Watch kids giggle while they paint and get messy always brings joy. However, often there are students who act out or show unexpected behavior or give up or refuse to work, or maybe they are the reluctant learners in your classroom, and sometimes kids just refuse to work without having tried the project at all. When students show unexpected behavior, it is usually because they don't either believe in themselves, or they believe they can't do the activity, or there might be some other barrier preventing that. Or maybe it's just like the relationship they have with you, they just don't trust you yet, and they're just not willing to start. And that's just, it just depends on, just could be a lot of things, right? So instead of asking for help, they instead make the choice to distract others, or sometimes just to be silly, which can be very frustrating for the teacher. Teaching growth mindset thinking to your students in your art classroom can teach them to change the way they think, to allow them to believe that they can create art if they practice and try, to know that mistakes help them actually learn, and that learning takes time and determination, and that we're all not expected to create the best art piece from the start, right? Otherwise, everybody would be a professional artist, right? But we're all at school just to learn, right? So instead of knowing like anything, learning the creative process is a journey and an adventure where you create, experiment, make mistakes, and encounter failures. They will know that it's okay to go through this journey because we're all lifelong learners. So design some growth mindset art lessons for your classroom and teach growth mindset to your kids. Design some art lessons that are going to really just teach them about being growth mindset thinkers. Or if you're just like, I just need a resource, you can totally grab my growth mindset for an art classroom resource that teaches growth mindset strategies in an art classroom setting. Grab it in my TPT store or grab the link in the show notes of this episode. Next is back to school directed drawing. So directed drawings are amazing for teaching students basic drawing skills and techniques. It teaches them hand-eye coordination and is a perfect opportunity to build their confidence in drawing. Reluctant learners often think they can't make art or draw, which is why we should always teach them, of course, growth mindset in our art classrooms. But if you can give them the opportunity to see they can, and start your kids off with easy to achieve lessons and goals with their directed drawings, then you're increasing the opportunity for all learners to see that they can make art and that they can draw. They just have to work at their own pace, and the more they try, the more they can do. So teach directed drawings to your students often over the first 2 months. You can just do it as like a morning activity or the start of the class. It can be the lesson. And just spend time increasing their confidence, okay? You can do this in older grades as well and just increase the skill and detail and complexity of the directed drawing, right? So you can change the level, more simple for your primary. Elementary, you can add some more details, but as you get older, of course, increase the complexity of it. So you can always do directed drawings, of course, with different art mediums. You don't have to just use pencil. You don't have to just use wax crayon. You can explore it with oil pastels or paint or both. You could do wax resist with your crayons and paint, whatever. It is a great way to introduce an art medium and teach a drawing skill. So I highly recommend that you do some directed drawings in the start of your back to school year. You can design your own directed drawings or grab my back to school themed directed drawings resource in my TPT store, Ms. Artastic. Again, click that little back to school categories after you search Ms. Artastic on TPT, or just grab the link in the show notes of the podcast to go there directly. All right, so once we have some basic skills and understandings done in our classroom, you've taught your routines, you've taught your expectations, you've engaged kids and community builders, you've taught them growth mindset, they have the mindset that they are going to create art and that they are all artists, then you must create some art. And the best way to do that is by creating some back to school themed art projects, just to give them a little bit of taste of making a fun art project. themed for back to school that you can use always, of course, as your display for Meet the Teacher Night, or perhaps you're just like your open house, whatever. So this is a perfect project just to get them excited about art making, and also is your first art project that you're going to wow your kids with, and of course the parents and everybody else in the school. So I'm going to give you guys four different ideas for back to school art projects. All four of these can of course be found in my Teachers Pay Teachers store as video art tutorials. So if you're wanting a different way of teaching, either you can learn from my video tutorials or you can play that video tutorial in your classroom. Honestly, kids love watching videos. I can teach an art lesson in my class. My kids are excited about it, but sometimes I'll also play my own videos of me creating, and it's like they have never listened better. I don't even have to ask them. They're just like, whoa, even though it looks the exact same, because they're watching my hands underneath a document camera make art usually. But then it's like if I put a video on, it's even more exciting. I don't know the difference or why this is, but I swear this is just, it is what it is, and things are changing. Even though it's me and it sounds, I don't know, it looks the exact same to me, but this is the reality. Okay, so the first art project I have is perfect for upper elementary or middle school. It's the Surrealist School Supplies art project inspired by Salvador Dali's Persistence of Memory. But of course, instead of having like a portrait and some clocks melting, this one brings school supplies into the works, and they are the one things that are melting in this art project. But of course, it's created in a Salvador Dali style. So create your some Surrealist School Supplies with your students this back to school and get them excited about art making by, and also through also exploring an art style or art movement right away. So you're exploring surrealism but in a back to school theme, and you also are, you can introduce Salvador Dali if you want at the same time. This art project does not, but you can introduce that into it. So you can use watercolor paints or tempera paint cakes to create a Surrealist School Supply artwork inspired by the art making style of Salvador Dali. Again, perfect for back to school, and you can grab this resource, which is a full video art tutorial and includes other additional resources, including a rubric, a lesson plan, finished example, step-by-step drawing handout, and the reflection pages to create this piece successfully. And it even has a bulletin board display sign, so you can just pop everything up and you're done. So you can visit my store, MizArtastic, to check out this resource or find the link in the show notes of this podcast. Remember, if you're visiting MizArtastic on TPT, by going to teacherspayteachers.com, searching MizArtastic, click that little back to school category and you'll find it there. And or you can just click the link in my show notes. All right, so that first one was Surrealist School Supplies. The next idea is that I've designed for this year, brand new, is Yayoi Kusama inspired apple art project. My friends, this is a great way to teach line, to introduce pattern. Of course, you're using contrast to create this piece, right? Because everything's very high contrast with Yayoi Kusama. And instead of doing a pumpkin, we're doing an apple. So I'm super excited about it. It also teaches oil, pastel, and paint resist techniques. So get your kids inspired by the art making style of Yayoi Kusama with this back to school art project. Again, it's in my Teachers Pay Teachers store, or you can find the link in the show notes of my blog. Next idea is to always make name word art that explores just who the kids are, and you can always use name word art projects as your about me. Okay, so absolutely get to know your students through making some name art is definitely a great way for them to ease into art making with a easy to achieve or do art project, but also allows them to explore who they are. This gives them the opportunity to share who they are with their classmates, and if you display in the school, they can share out to the community. In this fun, hands-on, and easy-to-do art lesson, students are going to be using watercolor paints or tempera paint cakes and choice art mediums, anything, to make name word art artworks. Perfect for back to school art. And then again, you can use this for your Meet the Teacher Night, back to school displays in the school, and you can use this as a about me activity. And you can grab this full video art tutorial with all the other resources that accompany this in my Teachers Pay Teacher store, or grab the link in the show notes of this podcast. Also, I have a primary lesson. So this year I created a primary rainbow snake art lesson where kids can learn their colors. So if you're just introducing colors to kids and the rainbow, then this is a great place to start. So learn about colors with this art project that allows students to create a rainbow snake artwork. In this fun, hands-on, and easy-to-do art lesson, students will use felt markers and soft pastels to create a rainbow back-to-school artwork that explores colors and learning colors. Perfect for back to school. So it's all about identifying colors. I'll be teaching that in the video. So again, you can just hit play in your classroom or teach it yourself. We're going to be learning colors. We're going to be learning how to use our felt markers as paint, or optional, you can add paint on top. But if you don't want to do paint right off the bat with primary, it's definitely designed to just use water to turn your felt markers into paint. And then you're going to also make a rainbow background with some soft pastels. So it's so fun for them to get messy and just really make some rainbow art that's going to pop and wow everybody at your school. They're going to be like, what? Primaries did this? And you're going to be like, yep, definitely. They're my kids. They're awesome. Anyways, so you're going to have them learning about colors and identifying colors in this project that is rainbow themed, that has snakes, that has rainbows. It's good for everybody. And again, it's a video step-by-step tutorial with all your rubrics, lesson plans, handouts, reflection sheets, of course, all at the primary level. Again, you can find that in my Teachers Pay Teacher Store, Mizartastic, or in the show notes of this blog. Okay, so once you're all done teaching and introducing back to school theme stuff, you have gotten your kids excited about making art in your art classroom, then it's time to teach them about the elements of art, which are the basic structures or elements of artworks. So from 2D to 3D artworks, it is impossible to make art without the elements of art. They are the foundation of art making. Of course, you can teach about the elements through making art. Again, the elements of art are color, value, line, shape and form, texture, and space. So my suggestion is to design units that will teach what each element are and then create a follow-up art project that will explore using the element as a focus for an art project. For example, you can create an art project that focuses on using the element of art line. For a complete elements of art unit bundle that will teach each element of art and also will allow you to have full elements of art, full art units for each element of art to allow you to be fully planned for the year. So each unit comes with 3 full art lessons in addition to a PowerPoint lesson that teaches about the element. Then check out my art unit bundle in my Teachers Pay Teacher Store, Mizartastic, or grab the link in the show notes. Or if you are still teaching remotely or are doing online teaching through distance learning, I also have an Elements of Art Introduction Digital Art Lessons resource, and that is a wonderful introduction to the 7 elements of art: color, line, value, shape and form, space and texture. And it's a digital booklet that's designed for Google Classroom with a Google Slides. And I also offer it as a PDF. So when you buy the resource, you get the PDF version, which can be used as a booklet and a simple, easy to do tutorial, perfect for art on the cart or digital, because it also comes with the Google Slides version, okay? And it can be the booklet can be printed again or offered on Google Classroom, and it introduces each of the 7 elements of art to your kids with an art tutorial for each element that allows students to choose which mediums they want to use. So that's why it is very good for doing either art on the cart or for distance learning, okay? So depending on if you are still doing some remote stuff or whatever your circumstances are, this is a great option, and that's my digital one, and you can find that link in the show notes or in my Elements of Art section of my TPT store. I also have tons of different Elements of Art resources, so just when you go to my Teachers Pay Teacher store on Mizartastic, when you go to my store, Mizartastic, on Teachers Pay Teachers, make sure you check that little button or category on the left side that says Elements of Art. So after you're done teaching the elements of art, teach the principles of design. So I like to go in an order, and I like to make each month kind of themed, either themes of art history or elements and principles. You can always, always, always embed different themes or art history into your elements and of art and principles of design projects, right? You can target multiple curricular competencies or content pieces with one project or one unit, right? Like you can teach art history and an element at the exact same time, or you can teach art history or an artist and a principle of design at the same time. You can target multiple things. So always keep that in mind when you are creating your art projects and are teaching them in your classroom. Don't overwhelm yourself. Just think like, how can I do multiple things with one project, okay? So the principles of design are structures that we use or consider when making our artworks to help us make art that is pleasing to the viewer. The principles of design are balance, contrast, emphasis, movement, pattern and repetition, proportion, rhythm, and unity and variety. After you teach the elements of art, wrap up your year by teaching the principles of design with a unit that explores what each principle of design is. And I always teach like different artworks or artists that use these principles. So that's how I tried to embed art history into my teaching, right? Like you do this for your elements too, like embed art history into this. So like, okay, we're looking at rhythm. These artworks and artists are represent rhythm being used in artworks from art history. Okay, so that is super important. Like we're not trying to teach an artist and a contrast, for example, separately. Bring it all together and attack those competencies or curricular content pieces in one go. Okay, so we just got to think about how there's not a lot of time in a day, and the year goes by really fast after you get past September and October, depending on when you start. Like I find the first 2 months are like slow, and then it's like all of a sudden it's like May or June and you're like, whoa, right? Depending on what time of the year you start and end or whatever, or maybe you end in December. Okay, but like the first 2 months are slow and then all of a sudden it's like, boom, you're running out of time. So just really think about how you can bring multiple things together. So especially when you're doing your year-long plan at the beginning of the year, just like really think about how you can do multi-curricular things in art. Okay, so after you teach each element of art, wrap up your year by teaching the principles of a design with a unit that explores what each principle of design is, and then explore it using a focused art project that shows that principle of design in action. So design some art principles of design art projects to use in your classroom with your students. And for a complete principles of design art unit bundle that explores all of these principles, check out my bundle in my Teachers Pay Teacher store, Mizzertastic, or click the link in the show notes of my blog. I also have a digital resource for that. So if you're still remote or you're teaching distance learning, make sure you check out that. It's also perfect for our On the Cart because again, it has flexible mediums. Or make sure you click that principles of design category in the left-hand side of my Teachers Pay Teacher store. That's going to give you all my principles of design resources. Here is your action item. I want you to make a plan for your first 2 months. So what are you going to teach in those first days, first weeks, first 2 months? How are you going to get to know all of your learners? How are you going to encourage them to make art and build their confidence? How are you going to teach them classroom routines in a fun and engaging way? How are you going to teach them about you? Remember, you are an art teacher boss, and you are confident, you are amazing, and you got this back to school. I believe in you, and you are going to rock it, own it, and just have fun with kids. Well, that's all for this episode. Happy back to school, and I wish you all the best this school year. Remember, not everything will work out perfectly, and that's okay. Just remember to have fun with your students. You are an art teacher boss. You got this. I'm Kathleen McGivern, Ms. Artastic, signing off.